If you're feeling like maybe I am autistic, what can you do? A diagnosis may bring you a lot of help. It could mean in-home support services. You could get different kinds of therapies, respite, which is paid babysitting that you don't have to pay for, the state pays for it. You could get into places that do equine therapy, which is super cool. It's just like talking to a psychologist while riding a horse. Kind of nice.
What are you trying to say? Anybody can miss a shot. Nobody misses when I'm at the end of the rope. You never had a rope around your neck. Well, I'm going to tell you something. When that rope starts to pull tight, you can feel the devil bite your ass.
And you might be able to get disability insurance. I'm in the middle of that myself, and fingers crossed. I don't expect it to go my way anytime soon, but it would change my life if it did. The stress of getting a diagnosis may not be worth it if you've figured out how to live your life. If you've got a couple of friends, if you have connections with your family, if you have a job that's working for you, it might not be worth it because it is extremely stressful. You may encounter, you likely will encounter a bunch of people that tell you you're not autistic, and people may want you to pay for some of the services, the insurance piece, and just getting doctors to listen to you. I have gotten so emotionally sick from trying to get the help that I need. So I don't want you to go through the same. But if you want that diagnosis, you can get it. You have to really educate yourself on that official diagnosis, the DSM-5, and just like tick those boxes, give them like lists of examples that fill their boxes. What you can do every day is meditation. It is the best thing, the best form of medicine that there is. No therapy of any kind will ever replace what meditation does. I can't tell you the kinds of evenness and emotional well-being that I get just from sitting and listening to the very quietest parts of myself. It evens out everything. All of my neurotransmitters seem to start vibing and being produced evenly. And it takes me to amazing places. And again, that's for a spiritual kind of video that I will talk about at some point. But even if you're not spiritual, being able to be quiet and just calm your nervous system is so important. I would love to give you the science on that. It's on my to-do list to study why exactly meditation works. Lower your standards for yourself and for other people. Stop trying to please everybody else and stop trying to tell yourself that you have to live up to some kind of expectation. That whole time thing that I was talking about, you very well may not understand time the way that other people do, and getting somewhere at a certain time in the morning may be really difficult. And honestly, you could argue that it is a reasonable accommodation to have flexible start and finish times. You can argue that it's a reasonable accommodation to work from home. The fact that companies don't make that accommodation is kind of a flaw in the system, and we need more disability lawyers lawyering their asses. But I think that it is definitely time for an at-home, at-your-own-pace revolution. That if you can only work from home on your own hours, that is totally legit and okay. And we need to make space for it. Don't play by other people's rules. It's really not worth it. You probably have your own, and they're probably good enough. It took me this long and a lot of pain and suffering in order to finally acknowledge the things that I actually knew when I was a teenager, and I drifted away from because adulthood is loud and everybody wants things from you. But just don't do it. Find your own way. Oh, and a really fantastic thing that you can do is if you have autism, you can go to the Department of Rehabilitation and they will pay for things like school, for a computer, for business startup costs. I'm in the beginning of process of that, so I don't know how successful people can be with it. I have a pretty significant executive dysfunction So it's really hard for me to remember to call people or know where my papers are or like that kind of stuff. So it hasn't worked out yet, but I that is a federal program that's in all 50 states. And if you have autism, they have to serve you. Remember friends. It's a really hard thing, and maybe you just have one friend, but it's quite possible that if you're autistic, your friends are autistic or at least neurodiverse in some way. I've recently discovered that every single person I've ever dated is autistic. And, you know, like that radar I was talking about, I've had it since I was really little, and I've always just like, ooh, that person is different. Ooh, that person is different. And of course, making friends is hard, but and keeping them is hard, but even if you just have that one person that's weird like you, that can totally be enough. And there's also really great Facebook groups for that are like total safe spaces. Don't even go somewhere that isn't a safe space. It's not worth it. If people are arguing, leave. There's other places. But that can make you feel validated, and that other people experience things weird and differently like you. All right. Well, I hope that this has been helpful. I hope this has been helpful. And if you have any questions, you're welcome to email me. I'll have my email link at the bottom. And I wish you well on your journey. And stay weird.